course, a regular here on Breakfast Television, Claude Martel, assistant professor of education at Concordia, our flight safety go-to person.
You're a crash guy.
But unfortunately, that's what it is. You know, Claude, honestly, there's so many, people have so many questions. The Malaysian Airlines flight, Air Algérie, TransAsia, it seems a lot of these incidents are happening at a very short distance in time. A big question, is it still safe to fly? People are panicked. We don't want to raise any, you know, alarms for no reason. What do you think?
If you look at the real numbers, like people driving, people taking the train and things like that, taking a plane is still the safest way to travel. Like, it's actually more dangerous to take your car this morning than to actually take a plane. So safety in general, it's much safer to take a plane. So there shouldn't be an issue there. Now, there's specific areas that people might be worried, like flying over a war zone or something like that.
So what is this? Is this just a bad coincidence? Are these just bad coincidences that all these things are happening?
Yeah.
Really?
Yep. Up to now, if you look, the real weird element that is happening right now is the clustering. Like the fact that they're happening so close together to each other. But there are incidents happening every year. Like probably the one in Ukraine is exceptional out of the other.
Because it was shot down.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But all the others are pretty, there are plane crashes that happen on a regular basis. It's just that it just happened so in like what, 3 months?
Yes.
We see all these planes happening together.
So at the end of the, so people are looking at these very spectacular images right now, and especially over these conflict zones as Ukraine is. What exactly is changing in terms of aviation? Because now we've got Ukraine, we've got Israel, in terms of no flight zones and in terms of the way people are going to be traveling. How significant are these incidents going to change? How significantly are they going to change the way we travel?
And they're going to change somewhat. That's why the ICAO did a special meeting this week. And what's happening right now, it's always the country that determines how safe a zone is.
The country where the airport is.
Where the flights is.
Okay.
So right now, for example, you were talking about Israel. Israel is doing their threat assessment and saying, is it safe or not? And they have to balance this out with the economic implication of closing their airports.
Right.
So different countries do different assessments.
Mm-hmm.
So you could remember when we were talking about Ukraine, some countries were actually doing more safer assessment. They were flying further away and some were flying for. So each country and each airline is doing their threat assessment separately. And that's probably what's going to change. There might be a more global perspective on this.
Meaning, so if the country decides that it's safe to land, the other countries can say, we're choosing a safer route?
It always happens like that. The airlines have to determine if they want. In Ukraine, we saw that Air Canada, British Airways, and many European flights decided to fly much further away
than Malaysian Airlines.
Exactly.
Let's talk specifically now about Israel. Not too long ago, actually last week, flight AC-84 had to circle Ben-Gurion Airport a day after it was cleared to fly back into Tel Aviv. Tell us a little bit about the decision-making process of the FAA to say, okay, it is now safe again for flights to go in. Meanwhile, they're, you know, allegedly, actually Hamas was bombing right next to the airport.
So,
how does that happen?
So whenever there's an airline or another country that wants to fly in another, they have a bilateral
agreement.
Agreement, thank you. And in this case, the U.S. and Israel were negotiating when will it be safe to do it.
Okay.
So Israel developed their threat assessment and they say, okay, for this period, we think it's safe. Now, we always get surprised, like having a bombing next to the airport hasn't been seen before.
Yeah,
and Israel,
this is unprecedented. This stuff is...
It is close to unprecedented.
Okay.
There have been a few types, but Israel has also ramp up their defense. Like they have like these missiles, dome missile that they're trying to put together to prevent missile to go in. Now we've seen that's not always perfect, and the missile that flew right next to the airport is one case like this.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm pretty sure right now the threat assessment has been revised. So it's almost on a minute-to-minute or hour-to-hour basis they're revising this. Now, as a passenger, you might say, oh, I'm in the plane, they might change the threat assessment as I fly. And actually, that's what they do. They are actually revising. And that's why the flight was circling around.
Because it was an ongoing situation. Of course, Claude Martel, we always like to have you here to sort of explain all of these sometimes very scary situations for us. Thank you so much for joining us
this
morning.